Brown, you've heard the statements that the family as well as law enforcement and the advocate had to say. I told you that you could speak. However, I will remind you again, these proceedings are recorded. Do you have anything you wish to say at this time? All right. You have a right to a trial, right to a trial by jury, and a right to have legal counsel to represent you on these charges. If you cannot afford to hire legal counsel, you can apply for the public defender. To do so for a general sessions charge, you can do so through this application that I'm sending back to you, or you can apply at the clerk of court's office. There is a $40 filing fee for that. In all general sessions court cases, you have a mandatory court appearance. Your initial appearance is scheduled for January the 10th, 2020 at 9:00 in the morning in the general sessions courtroom. Do you know where that is? It is mandatory. If you fail to appear, a bench warrant will be issued for your arrest. You have the right to request a preliminary hearing on all these charges. Do you know what a preliminary hearing is?
Yes, ma'am.
You have 10 days to complete that request for a preliminary hearing and get that back to one of the magistrates. You'll receive a two-page checklist. It states it is your right and obligation to be present at trial. Trial may proceed in your absence if you fail to attend. If you are tried in your absence and found guilty, a bench warrant will be issued for your arrest. It also goes over things that we have already discussed, the fact of the matter that you have 10 days to request a preliminary hearing, the $40 filing fee for the public defender. If the charges that have been brought against you are dismissed, null pros, or you're found not guilty, they may be expunged from your record. And as a defendant, you are required to keep the court notified of any change of address until the final disposition of these charges. Mr. Brown, all of these charges will be heard in general sessions court as they stem from the same incident. I did review your criminal history as well as anything we have active in our system. I do know that you have some pending charges because I was the judge that set the bond on those. The hit and run with the driver's duty involving an accident in which death resulted is a charge in which I can deny bond, and I am choosing to do that on today's date. I will deny the bond on all of these charges. You can apply for that public defender. They can request that you be taken in front of a circuit court judge to have a bond set. Do you understand what is taking place today? Good luck to you, sir.
Thank you.